It was pretty hot. That's all I can say. This is rough.
Mac, what? Send help.
Hi, I'm Tom Gleason, and you're watching Heat Pump Hot Takes. We're here to talk about heat pumps today, and as the wings get spicier, so do the questions. With me is Mac Prather from Denver's Office of Climate Action, Sustainability, and Resiliency. Mac, thanks for being on Heat Pump Hot Takes today.
Thanks, Tom. Glad to be here and talk about heat pumps. A little nervous about the spice level today.
I am very excited about the spice level today and look forward to seeing how we both compare. So we have veggie wings from a local Denver wing restaurant. We have our first sauce. It's a sweet barbecue. Sound good?
Sounds great. Let's get started. It's good.
So my first question to you, Mac, is what is a heat pump and how does it work?
So a heat pump, what most people need to know is that it is just an upgrade from your basic air conditioner. It's able to heat and cool your home.
And it does both heating and cooling.
That's exactly right.
Okay. So let's give the mild a try, see how it stacks up. Barbecue, not bad. How you feeling so far?
Oh, feel good. This is easy.
Well, that's nothing. So a heat pump is kind of like a furnace and an air conditioner all in one. What does it look like? What does a heat pump look like? What does it sound like?
A heat pump is gonna look very similar to the air conditioner you're familiar with. Just a big kind of beige box on the side of a building. Very similar look, a little bit nicer and a little bit more quiet and tolerable. For most people, it's gonna look just like the same equipment. You might be able to tell if you're really familiar with the equipment, but it's not really a big difference at all.
Your eyes are watering. I'm doing great. All day, son. Okay, thanks, Mac. Let's jump to our next sauce and our next question. Do heat pumps work well in older or existing buildings? How do they perform there?
It's a really good question, and it's one I hear a lot. So we know that they can work in older buildings, certainly. Again, anywhere you have that air conditioner, heat pump is a great choice. We do want to talk about a couple other things in old buildings and specifically old homes, because they tend to be leakier, they tend to be not as well insulated. So we would always suggest that a homeowner starts with an energy audit. That's going to tell you a lot of information about the home. You can get a rebate from Xcel Energy for that, and it'll kind of set you on track to increase the comfort and efficiency of your home. Two, do your weatherization and your insulation first. So get those cracks sealed, get those windows sealed, and add a nice blanket to your home. That'll make you more comfortable and efficient, save you money right away. Three, then you should start making the plan for that equipment.
How do heat pumps perform in very cold temperatures? We know here in Colorado, we can see sub-freezing temperatures on a regular basis. Mm-hmm. How is a heat pump gonna do there?
We do get those cold days here in Denver. Last winter, 2022, I think it got down to negative 20 Fahrenheit outside, which is very cold. And we had a lot of examples of heat pumps, even in older homes, performing and heating the home on those coldest nights. So they do work in the cold temperatures in Denver. Not all heat pumps are created equal. So again, it's really important to plan your project. You want to work with contractors that you can trust and that can give you good information. And if you want to heat your home exclusively with that heat pump or rely on that for most of your heating, be sure to emphasize that to your contractor. And you'll get the equipment and the technology that's able to do that.
Mac, where does the heat come from? When it's, you know, below freezing outside, where does a heat pump get heat from?
Yeah, that is a little spicier question. The heat pump technology, again, just very similar to the air conditioner, instead of generating heat like a furnace, it's moving heat from one place to another place. So even on those coldest days when it's negative 20, there's still enough heat out there outside your home that technology can pull it in and dump the heat inside. In the summer, it works in the opposite direction. It pulls the heat out of your house and dumps it outside.
So as we're spicing things up, what is the impact of a heat pump on someone's electric bill?
That's a great question, Tom. The impact of going to a heat pump on your utility bill is a little bit nuanced. It is a spicy question, and that is spicy sauce. And it hits a little delayed. There is nuance because it really depends on the home and the equipment that you have. If you're going from electric resistance or baseboard heating, that's almost always going to save you money to make the switch to a heat pump. But we can't guarantee that you'll save money right now switching from the furnace to the heat pump because of the changes of those natural gas and electric prices. So in 2022, we saw a pretty big spike in natural gas heating over the winter, and that caused a lot of pain for folks who are, you know, paying their heating bills, trying to heat their home with natural gas. In general, the cost of that natural gas is pretty volatile. Changes from year to year, from season to season, and it's a little bit unpredictable. The cost of electricity, on the other hand, is very predictable, and it raises at a slow and steady rate compared to that change in natural gas. So what we can say is that we expect those to be more predictable, and in the future we expect that electricity to be more reliable and a good choice for homeowners to use the heat pump.
Okay, well, let's spice it up some more. You ready for another question? Why should someone install a heat pump? Why should someone care? Why does this even matter? And how hot is this wing?
It's very hot. oh man, why should you care about a heat pump? it's gonna be more comfortable for your home. Ooh. It is gonna be better for the climate. It's gonna be more efficient, and it's gonna be healthier. You're getting rid of that natural gas and shifting to more electric. So that's what we wanna encourage people to do. Ooh, there's also, there's dollars out there, so there's a ton of incentives. It's an upgrade for your home. That's a good one.
That one was hot. That one was definitely hot. All right, Mac, we got one sauce left. We got a slight burn going. Let's finish this thing. I can't feel my tongue. Oh, this looks
it's
different.
It's not going away
This
either.
Looks different. This looks like it's hotter. Mac, keep it together. Mac, how does a heat pump work though? Like, really?
Basically, you're pumping refrigerant around and you're pulling heat out of the air, pushing it into your home. That's all I can say. This is rough.
Mac, what?
Send help. Mac, pardon my sweat. What resources are available? Like, does Denver, you're telling us why heat pumps are so great. They sound pretty cool. Are there any resources? Is there any help for me to cool my tongue or to get a heat pump?
As a homeowner, as a consumer, a renter in Denver, we'd love for you to visit www.denvergov.org/heatpump-rebates. There's information on incentives. There's educational information on heat pumps, how to buy heat pumps, how to plan for these projects, and how to work with contractors. So that's where I would tell anyone to go.
Mac, this has been extraordinarily helpful and burning. Mm-hmm. I really appreciate you coming on to speak with me today and to tell me a little bit more about how heat pumps work and the benefit. So hopefully we can all go home and cool down with a heat pump and maybe a bucket of ice cream.
Thanks, Tom.
Thanks, Mac.
Ah.